Hello, everybody. I've got a really cool story today. On Tuesday, April the 24th, it was announced that a company called Planetary Resources is starting up with backing from the likes of James Cameron or Larry Page, who's the CEO from Google, financing this little venture, which is designed to reduce the overall cost of traveling in space. That's especially exciting because, as you can imagine, it's really expensive to send people out to the moon or wherever in space. And what this will do is find ways in which we can harvest resources from asteroids to help us with space travel. Now, you might be wondering why going up in space and mining will somehow save costs. Well, one of the big costs from getting into space of getting into space is fuel. It's probably one of the most expensive aspects of sending a rocket in there because you need a lot of rocket fuel. But you don't just need rocket fuel to take off. Also need rocket fuel to get around, and once you land on the moon, you need rocket fuel to leave. And this just compounds on how much you need to carry with you into space to begin with. It's a little difficult to understand what it means to have enough fuel to escape Earth's gravity and travel around, so I've sort of cooked up a little analogy, and hopefully this will help clarify it a little.
And here is a small diagram I put together to help explain why it's so cost-effective to be able to refuel in outer space. In that the top section there, you can see what normal trips would look like. You can think of it as a horse-drawn carriage. So to haul up those red space horses, which is what we're basically using to get back to Earth, you need two white horses to begin with. Because you've got all that extra weight there. And once you get up to space, you toss aside the white horses, and then you use the red ones. Now, if you can get your fuel in outer space, and you look in that bottom diagram, you see there's only one white horse. Since you don't have to haul the red horses up, you can get by with just one because that's less weight you need to bring with you to space. And then once you go to space, you can pick up one of those lovely space horses from a fueling station and head back to Earth. Overall, you can see it would be way cheaper to have only one white horse going up with you and then swipe in some horses from an asteroid passing by, whereas up top you've got to have two white horses and you have to buy the red space horse as well. So the bottom one is way more cost effective, and so that's why being able to fuel from asteroids would greatly reduce the cost of space flight. I hope that made sense.
So now that you have a better idea of why it's so important we have means of finding resources in outer space which can act as fuel, maybe you can better appreciate what Planetary Resources is trying to do, and more specifically what they're trying to do is find asteroids which have water on them, and the water can be converted into liquid nitrogen, which acts as a propellant. And it should be noted that the most fuel we will need is still to take off from the Earth. It's sort of the big problem, I suppose, and the one thing Planetary Resources can't fix. You need a heck of a lot of rocket fuel to take off, and that's the most rocket fuel you need, because what you're essentially doing when a rocket takes off is escaping Earth's gravity. And when we're talking about asteroids or the moon, the gravity is a lot smaller, so you need a lot less rocket fuel. But still, reducing the amount of fuel you'll need to get back reduces the overall costs to begin with, and I hope my analogy worked in explaining that, and I won't have to go over that again. It still doesn't replace that huge cost of rocket fuel up front, but again, lowering the cost substantially in other factors, in other areas, rather. So, in the words of Neil deGrasse Tyson, this project, as fanciful as it may sound, is indeed no bullshit. And I'm really looking forward to seeing the results. Thanks for watching. Love, Science.